My name is Stanislaw Robert Luberda, and this is lesson 8 of 10 in my Premiere Pro Introductory course. In this lesson, we're going to be talking all about audio in Premiere Pro. You may remember our timeline here from the last couple projects we were working on, and I've created my adjustment layer, created a look on here, and I've kind of cut this up. We've edited some of these videos together, and you may notice I've got a few more things on my screen here. Before we jump right into audio, I want to have a quick conversation about audio in Premiere Pro. Premiere Pro can handle audio in lots of different ways. The first thing I want to talk about with audio is that audio, unlike video, is accumulative. What do I mean by that? Well, if I have two stacks of video, one on top of the other one, I'm only going to see the topmost video here. I'm not going to be able to see through to that other one because they're both 100% opaque. However, with audio, if I have 10 people in a room, it's going to be 10 times as loud than as if I had just a single person. To illustrate this, I'm going to mute my audio down here, and I've got this little mute button right down here, so now this track won't play, and I've got some audio playing in through here. So I'm just going to play this back, and you'll notice that my audio waveform is right around -3 there. If I play that same section of video, but now with our audio music bed in here, you'll see that it's already much louder, and in fact it is clipping because it is combining all the audio into one master output. So how can we lower some of this audio? Well, I need to see a little bit more room in through here. So I'm actually going to highlight over my video one and my audio one tab, and I'm just going to scroll with my wheel here, and that's opened up my video. And I'm going to do the same with my audio so I can see my audio waveforms a little bit better. You can also drag in between these different layers just so we can see things a little bit better. I'm going to rearrange my panels here. I can click on this wrench here and show my video thumbnail. So that's going to turn on or turn off my video thumbnails. You may notice that I've got this line that's going across all my audio tracks here. This is actually my volume. If I double click this guy here and opens up in my source monitor and go to my effect controls, you'll notice now we've talked all about our video effects, and under my audio effects, I have levels and bypass. And if I just drag down this level, you'll notice it says right now -8.78. Well, now this is much quieter than it just was. In fact, you can see that number here has changed to -8.8. And so I could just drag my audio down here so that way we don't hear it. What if I wanted to delete some of my audio, but leave my video here? If I select this clip and I hit delete, that's going to delete both of them. That's not necessarily what I want. In this case right here, I have 4 different channels of audio. However, in these 2, they're completely blank. So how can I remove just these channels? If I hold on to Alt Option, it lets me selectively choose just one piece. In fact, this is really useful if I want to do that with just video as well. In my case here, I'm just going to select each of these, holding on my Alt Option button, and I'm going to rearrange these into that same channel. In fact, I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to even remove these loud ones as well. So now effectively I just have one audio track of all my audio that was captured with my video, and then I have a soundtrack. To organize my clips a little bit better, I usually put my soundtrack at the very bottom here, and I'll rename this by right-clicking it and rename, and I'm going to call this sound bed. Just that way I visually know which clip this is. And because I don't want to mess around with this one right now, I'm just going to lock it. Just in case I want to rearrange some things, I don't want to accidentally move this here. So now I've got my audio that's a little bit quieter here, and I can see that I still want to make that quite a bit quieter. It can be a little tricky here to get my levels exactly where I want them. In most cases, I like to keep a little bit of ambient sound so we know what that is, but this is also letting me know that maybe my music bed is a little too loud. So I'm actually going to drag down my music bed. I can see a visual representation on the right side here of my audio meters. As a good rule of thumb, you typically want your audio meters between -6 and about -12 here. I'm going to give this a little bit of room here, and I'm just going to rename this track to our VO, our voiceover track. And what I'm going to do here is right click my voiceover settings, and it's just going to give me a visual representation of how loud I'm coming in right now. If I want countdown sound cues, if I want a pre-roll, which means it's going to start 3 seconds beforehand, and a post-roll of 2 seconds afterwards, to give myself some handles, and to give myself some time to prepare to do my voiceover. I'm going to mute my computer just so that way it doesn't pick up the audio from its own output. So I'm going to go ahead and hit record and start recording. This last spring, I took a trip to Thailand. It was a very beautiful trip. I got to see a lot of sights that I've never seen before. And that's good enough for me right now. Now if I go ahead and I play that back, you can see that my audio meters are much louder again. Really hard to tell exactly how loud something is and how quiet something is. So if I jump into my audio panel here, I can clearly see several different audio meters. These represent the different audio tracks that I have right down here. Now, this is different than if I was just moving these up or down. I can actually affect the whole track at once. So it's almost like this whole track has a master volume, and I can do the same thing with this audio track too to really bump that up and pull this down for my sound bed. Now I'm going to rearrange this a little bit here, and I have one more thing that I want to do. I'm going to change back to my editing mode, and what I want to happen here is I want the audio to dip. So I want the music to be very loud here, and then get quieter here, and then get loud again. If you remember from our last lesson when we were talking about effects, I can do that with keyframes. So if I double click this and open up my effect controls, I can go into my volume and I can animate the levels changing across time. So as a quick example, I'm going to create a keyframe here, and then we're going to drop this down to, let's say, -17. So now I have those two keyframes really close together here. And if you take a look at my timeline down here, I've got those two keyframes right here. If I play this back,
this last spring, I took a trip to Thailand.
You can clearly hear that the audio has gotten quieter to make room for my audio voiceover. I'm going to undo that here really quick, just get rid of those keyframes, and I have a much better, easier way to do that. One tool that we haven't looked at quite yet is our pen tool. And our pen tool lets us create those keyframes right in our timeline. So if I just click here and click and drag another one here, that's effectively just done the same thing I've done before. And I'm going to make another one here and raise this one right back up. It's a little tough to get exact numbers using our little rubber band here. So if I need more precise control, I can come up to my effect controls. Using these buttons here, I can navigate to specific keyframes and change their variables. So I'm going to zoom out here and let's see what that looks like.
This last spring, I took a trip to Thailand.
And clearly we can see that my audio meters are great. I can hear my audio clearly here. In fact, if I want to make this a bit louder, I can raise this up as well.
I took a trip to Thailand.
And there you go. That is working with audio in Adobe Premiere Pro. One quick thing about audio in general. Right now, I have some music here that I've gotten from Poddington Bear, and I'm using it just for the demo here. I'm not displaying it or anything like that because I may not have the license for that music. I want you to be very aware that to use music most of the time, you need to have a license for it. Doesn't matter if you're not making money off of it. Most music, just like stock video or photography, needs to have the license to get that. So where do I find music to use in my productions? Well, there's a couple places that I go to right away. Luckily for you, if you have access to Adobe Creative Cloud or even CS6 and above, there's the Adobe Audition downloads. It is provided free as long as you have access to Adobe Creative Cloud, and there you can find several sound effects, music loops, and beds. However, I don't think that they've updated this in about 4 or 5 years. Most of these are fairly old, and this coming soon has said coming soon since about 2012. A lot of this is going to be fairly generic, and you've probably heard it a million times before. A better place that I go to for most of my music is Audio Jungle. Audio Jungle is great, and by the way, they have not paid me for an endorsement in this. Audio Jungle is great because it lets me find specific kind of music in very clear license terms. So if I just click on this one right here, this is a creative, and I can click on this, and it gives me a preview. In fact, I can download a watermarked preview to put into my file. And then it has several different licenses. So this is the music standard license. We have a broadcast, mass reproduction, music broadcast for a broadcast audience of up to 10 million, and broadcast and film. So very quickly and very easily, I can pick my different kinds of music. We can choose between different categories, different tags, price points, lengths, and even tempo or if it's looped. If you use the link in the description, I actually get an affiliate credit to that. Doesn't cost you anything extra, but by using my link, you end up supporting me. So if you've enjoyed any of my tutorials and you're looking to pick up music, I just ask that you use my link. Using music, you can't just use iTunes and grab some music that you've bought. You don't actually own that music and it is not licensed for reproduction. So be aware of that. In our next lesson, we're going to add some titles to this and wrap up this project. Again, my name is Stanislaw Robert Luberda with AV Ultra. This has been my introduction to Premiere Pro free course, and hopefully you found this useful.